Hello and welcome back to episode 2 of our series on Canva for Teams. I'm Claydan, and if you're watching this, I'm guessing you've experienced branding headaches. Branding inconsistency is a slippery slope that ends in a valley of despair, and believe me, it takes a lot of work to get your creative back on brand. So, how do you avoid that slippery slope and strengthen and scale your brand? Our Canva for Teams expert, Rachael, will show us how. Let's take a look. Building a strong and authentic brand is hard, and maintaining it can be even harder. Keeping your content consistent deepens your customers' understanding of what your brand represents and helps build trust in your brand. We know brand management is a challenge when you have lots of team members creating content independently and to tight deadlines. So here are some common challenges we hear from our community. My team is creating off-brand content again. I can't find the most recent logo files and brand colors or fonts. And it's super challenging to keep up with design demands and keep design assets on brand. Canva has a super helpful tool to save your team a ton of time and ensure they design on-brand content every time. It'll come as no surprise that Canva for Teams makes this easy with Brand Kit, Brand Controls, and Templates. Your Brand Kit can solve so many common branding challenges, especially when there are lots of cooks in the design kitchen. It's simple to set up and share your Brand Kit with your team, and turning on specific brand controls guarantees that assets will stay on brand all the time. So, first things first, what is a Brand Kit? Well, it provides you and your team with a usable version of your brand style guide. It makes building a brand from scratch easy, and for established brands, ensures consistency by allowing you to save and preset your brand identity in Canva. Brand Kit means you and your team can update any design or asset, so it's on brand with a single click. Let's hear from Rachael, a B2B educator at Canva, to tell us more.
Brand Kits and Brand Controls lighten your workload by keeping your brand consistent. They're two of my personal favorite Canva tools and solve so many common branding challenges. So let's look at how to set up your Brand Kit and Brand Controls. From your homepage, you'll see this Brand tab within your side panel. Your Brand tab is where you'll find all of your favorite branding tools, like your Brand Kit, Brand Templates, and for your team admins, you'll also see Brand Controls. So, let's set up a Brand Kit for our team homely. Firstly, I'm going to upload our brand logos. I always recommend uploading logos as SVG files. SVG format allows you to manipulate the logo colors within the editor, which is especially useful if you want to have different color variations of your logo. Next up is brand colors. I'm actually going to set up two different color palettes for my brand, one for primary colors and one for secondary colors, just to make it a little bit easier for my team members. I'll go ahead and add my primary colors to my primary color palette. You can add your colors using hex codes, and a feature I particularly love is that you can now also add CMYK codes. So CMYK codes are really important if you ever plan on printing your designs. They ensure that the colors you're seeing on the screen match the colors you see on your printed design. Cool, well, both of my color palettes are pretty much good to go, so let's now go ahead and add our brand fonts. Here I'm going to add a heading, subheading, and body font. If you can't find your brand font in the list, you also have the option to upload a custom font. And there's even more good news. You can now set up multiple brand kits and switch between them in seconds, making it even easier to keep your designs and your team on brand. Okay, now back to our favorite brand tab. Well, it's my favorite anyways, but the new feature that is now available to all size teams is brand controls. team admins have access to these built-in controls, which ensure that your team won't deviate from your brand when designing. You can turn on color and font controls that restrict members to only brand colors and fonts, and my favorite being design approvals. Design approval is a great one if you'd like to encourage members to gain approval of their designs before publishing. And if you'd like to adjust your members' design permissions even further, take a look at the permissions tab within your account settings. Here you can control if your team can use Canva's content in their designs, how your team can publish designs within Canva, and how they bring content into Canva. Brand controls and permissions are a serious game changer for brand consistency and keeping every team asset on brand. Team admins have access to these built-in brand controls to ensure that your team won't deviate from your brand when designing. This is a serious game changer for brand consistency and keeping every asset on brand.
BrandKit really does take the guesswork out of brand consistency. And if you'd like some guidance on setting up your BrandKit, we have a handbook available. Just scan the QR code or click the link in the video description. So what's next for making the most of Canva for Teams? Well, once you've set up your brand in Canva, you want to empower your team to create truly great work. Make sure you check out the next video in our team series to learn all about how you can boost your team's creative output by creating unbreakable templates for your team to use. We'll also be sharing handbooks so you can practice your skills. And remember to subscribe to our channel so you never miss a video.